coming up. We are on your side today, but with some potentially life-saving tips. A dog expert is here with us to show you what you need to know so you can avoid the possibility of being attacked by a dog while you're walking, jogging, the kids at the bus stop. All right, this is a happy dog.
Yeah, but not we're gonna this dog. This dog's not gonna attack you.
No, we'll learn some great tips next.
All right, so kids and college students are back in class, and that means many of them are walking to school.
So true. Scotty McConaughey is here, my friend from Canine Ponderosa, and today we're going to talk about some tips to help you avoid getting attacked by dogs. Yikes. I must say your dog is really not all that life-threatening right now. However, we do have a 6'6 attack dog right here that we can always defer to. Introduce us to Oreo.
This is Oreo. Aww. He's world famous. He's in a cartoon that won the 2011 Telly Award.
Aww.
And he's probably been on TV about 15 times. He was even in a movie.
Wow. He's such a sweetheart.
So this dog's more famous than all of us.
That's so true. So true. Scotty, you know, you and I were talking about this not too long ago about the attack thing and how, you know, the kids are going back to school. They're at the bus stop. People jog, don't think about it. And a lot of people, unfortunately, have their dogs off leads, too. So right. In this time, is it something that's so prevalent, dog attacks?
Well, maybe you saw, I posted on my Facebook, how many people have been attacked by a dog or when they're out on a walk, and like 70 people chimed
wow.
in. And a lot of them was recent. So it happens very common. It happened to you, right?
It did.
It happened to you, too, I think, right?
As a youngster, I was actually chased by a couple dogs. Now,
wow.
Fortunately, I'm an athlete, so I can jump and
yeah.
Get over fences, and most dogs can't do that. But what do you do if you cannot hurdle a fence?
Well, I would like to freeze, give them no motion. I'm police canine certified, so that's one of the things we do when we teach a dog to bite is we move around. So if you're moving and wiggling, they're gonna, you know, they're attracted to movement.
Mm.
So we would freeze. You could even do a sound to kind of cut them off. You could say something like "houch," H-O-U-C-H.
Why?
Because nowhere in the dog world do you hear the word "no," but puppies do make that sound when they're with their litter mates. If they use their teeth inappropriately, that puppy will say "houch," and this one goes, "Oh my gosh, I'm sorry." That's nature teaching. Dog bite inhibition or dog bite pressure control.
Okay, tell us if this is truth or not. Do you avoid eye contact?
Yes, that's a threat because dogs are predators.
So when you're standing there, like I had two German Shepherds, right, both of them were going at me from either side, and I just froze as much as I could, and I just...
Right.
No. I mean, but see, I was really quiet doing it that way.
It's good you didn't take my advice then.
He could get away with it, but you can't.
No.
So you did instinctually. You froze. You gave them no motion to come after it. And some of the things you want to do is, if you're going to go for a walk in the neighborhood, you want to scout the neighborhood. Go for a drive in the car, walk, and look for dogs that are in the backyard or in the house. They're free, smashing their head against the window.
Yeah.
So dogs are predators, and if they're not being managed by their owners, then they're in the backyard exhibiting predatory behavior, marching around. The mailman comes, they bark at the mailman. The mailman leaves. Now they think, whoa, you know, I got some power here. And then, God forbid, one day the mailman shows up, and he looks at the dog in the eyes, and he's delivering a package, and now it's game on, right?
Wow.
So they almost get more aggressive as they
build
see
confidence.
Your kind of fear. It makes them more confident.
That's right.
So we're going to scout out the area. We're going to look for possible danger. You said have something in your hand when you're walking, right?
Umbrella, a walking stick,
okay.
Even a bag like this.
Oh, show
right
us
here.
How the bag works.
So you could, like, if he was, Oreo was attacking me, I could block like that. But
with
see,
a
this
purse
is,
or whatever the case may be.
Anything.
He looks vicious.
A clipboard, a briefcase, a hat, a belt, anything will work.
Really?
But this is defense. So what I would suggest is be offensive and use something like a stick.
Yeah.
Even a lot of people are using tasers, and they don't have to tase the dog. They just will show the taser, and the dog will see the sparks, and they'll back off.
Oh, interesting. Now, you had mentioned, okay, so we've gotten to the stage where the dog approaches. Let's talk about once a dog approaches, what do you do, Scotty?
Well, if a dog is already up on you barking, freeze, okay? Now, if their intensity is this high, you have to go higher than that, and so that's why I would use the houch, and I've never seen the houch actually not work. So this is how, I'm an old school quarterback, you didn't know that.
Oh.
So this is how that houch would work. I would say, "Houch!" Right? And my intensity has to be higher than the dog's intensity if they're sitting there barking at me.
Oh, my gosh.
And if it doesn't work, right, and they get to the point where they actually do latch onto you, then that's a whole other.
Let's
so you're literally trying to match the intensity and kind of, you know,
be above
really intimidate the dog and trump that intensity.
Trump it,
try to defeat it psychologically.
Yeah, it's either that or you're trying to hike a football. I don't know.
Right.
One of the two.
Well, God forbid the dog attacks.
Okay, so if a dog latches onto you, you want to make yourself basically be a dead animal. You're dead, and don't give them any movement.
Go limp.
Right? And if that doesn't work, then you're going to have to choke the dog out. You're going to have to get your belt off. You're going to have to grab the collar. And whatever you do, don't fall down, because if you fall down, that can result in a mauling.
They have the advantage.
Oh, my gosh. So Is there anything to, like, get the eyes, gouge the eyes, try to do anything like that? Is there a certain...
Well, I mean, you have to be a pretty good athlete. I mean, he may be able to get away with that, you know what I mean? But your average person, even me, I don't think if a big pit bull or a German Shepherd come up, I'm not going to be able to gouge eyes or kick the throat or anything like that.
Right.
So you can defeat a dog psychologically.
So you got your freeze, you got your
Houch.
You got a barrier, and worst case scenario, don't get on the ground.
Right.
If for some reason that happens.
You choke them out, too, if you
have to. You go for the throat.
Okay, mm-hmm. All good tips. We hope we don't have to use any of them for sure. Hey, you have an event. Tell everybody about your event.
We have a dog rescue event on Saturday from noon to 3 at the K9 Ponderosa. Come on out. We have some very good guitar players that are playing. Free hot dogs and pop, and we're just trying to give back.
Oh, you got Donna McGavro playing.
Yeah.
Oh, great. Awesome. It's all free. And I will say that Devil Dog, you got the mean out of the brat. She's still a little brat, but you got the mean out of her.
She looks
great. You did a great job with her.
Thank you very much.
All right.
Thank you.